You better shine on them, baby, you're a star. You better be exactly who you are. Welcome to my channel. I'm Moon Sparkle, and today I have decided to give you guys an update on my motorcycle journey. So this is going to be more of a storytelling. So I do hope that you can stay with me for the whole story. I enjoy storytelling. I think it's a bit of an art. So let's see how I do. So the name of this story is going to be I got my motorcycle endorsement. But before I get into like the story of how I got my motorcycle endorsement, I kind of want to give you guys just some content, like some backdrop, some history, just so you can see and dive deeper into my story. So. The year was 1999 or early 2000s. I was sitting on the couch with my first husband, and it was late at night, and we were talking about like our future. And somehow we got on the topic of motorcycles, and what we agreed to at the time is that we would not get a motorcycle until the kids were older. Well, guess what, y'all? The kids are grown and they are okay and they are thriving. My kids are the ages of 27, 24, and 22. So guess what? It's time for mama to get a motorcycle. So fast forwarding, the year is 2012. I'm dating this amazing guy by the name of Blue, and he happens to own a motorcycle. During this time in which I'm dating him, I grow really close with his family, and me and his sister are driving in my car, and we end up getting in a car accident in which it's like a hit and run. So he hits the car, he keeps going. Anyways, kind of long story, kind of short story, but police end up coming. He ends up like, after he hits us, he drives a little bit further, hits somebody else, drives a little bit further, hits somebody else. Anyways, police come pick us up. We go ID the guy. I decide to go home and be by myself because my car is now totaled. I feel some type of way. Later on that night, Blue comes over and he's a bit disappointed. Like, hey, you just got in a car accident. You know, me and my family love you. Why are you not with us? Like, why are you over here all by yourself? We have this challenging breakthrough conversation. And the way the conversation ends is, you can come and be with me and my family so that we can love on you, but the only way to get there is going to be on the back of my bike. Instantly, my fear like rises up inside of me, and it's something I want to do, but I'm scared. I don't even want him to know I'm scared. We talk through it because he only lived like two exits away from me. We map the whole thing out. He gives me his helmet. I agree to get on his bike. I'm on the back of the bike, scared, adrenaline rushing, on the back of the bike. And instead of him going straight to his house, he skips the exit, takes an extra exit. And anyways, I mean, that was my first experience on a bike. It was a rush. It was thrilling. My wig was tow. I mean, so that was my first experience on the bike, on a motorcycle. And at that point, I knew like this was something that I wanted to do, but how was I gonna get over like this fear that I was feeling? Fast forwarding, the year is 2014, and I'm on this dating app by the name of POF, and I'm chatting with a gentleman by the name of Jamal, and we are just chatting like back and forth, back and forth. And we're getting to the point, you know, when you're on that dating app, you're getting to the point of like wanting to meet the person. So we agreed that we want to meet each other. But our first encounter from meeting each other was me picking his ass up on the side of the highway after his ass fell off of his bike. Yes. So he fell off his bike. I go pick him up, take him to the hospital, sit with him in the ER, and I sit and wait with him until his family arrives. So that was my second encounter with a motorcycle. At that point, I'm still wanting a motorcycle, but I'm just like, the reality is your ass could fall off the bike, you know, and what do you do to prevent that situation from happening? I don't think he had his endorsement. I don't think he had went to any safety school. I think he just got on his bike. Fast forwarding, the year is 2020, and it's a whole mood, it's a whole vibe. I mean, you know, 2020 for a lot of people felt kind of renaissance type, like people were really diving into their art and their creativity. So the year, like I said, is 2020, and I'm in front of Sunset Kava, and it's poetry night. I think either I had done some poetry or I was hosting poetry night, but anyways, it was really lit and it was just a mood. And a group of us were standing in front of Sunset Kava, and one of the regulars who would come to poetry night had his own motorcycle, and he happened to ride his bike that night. And at this point, this is gonna be like my third encounter. And I asked him, hey, can I have a ride on the back of your bike? And he was like, sure. So I hopped on the back of his bike and we just rode like just one exit. At that point, I was still having that rush. My fear wasn't as intense as it had been the first time I had been on the bike. So, I mean, by the time I asked him to get on the back of his bike, I knew this was something that I wanted. Like, I still wanted a bike. And so I think in manifesting or working on your goals, it's like, if you see the opportunities as they present themselves, it's like, why don't you go for it? So at this point, I'm damn near begging folks to let me get on the back of their bike, you know. So that was my third encounter with motorcycles. So I just wanted to share a bit of my history with motorcycles before I dive into the story of how I got my motorcycle endorsement. So I'm sharing this part for people who want a motorcycle or who are in the process of getting their endorsement and their family and friends don't support them. I know I experienced this once I really began to vocally express that I wanted my motorcycle, and I would express this to, at the time, my coworkers who were like my friends and family and they were my community. But what I experienced was a lot of negativity. I now know that, you know, they did care, but I do know that people will project their fears onto you. So I received a lot of negativity when I would express that I wanted my motorcycle. And although it was a bit discouraging, what I learned from that is you don't need to share all your plans and goals with people, because everybody don't mean you well. Some people don't want to see you happy. People can be so protective and wanting to keep you safe that they could cause you not to live your life. You know, we're gonna die anyway. That's literally what we come here to do, is die. Like, that's the end game, that's the goal. We're gonna die. How it happens, nobody knows. Yes, are motorcycles dangerous? Yeah, but I mean, a lot of things are dangerous. I think that if you prepare yourself and equip yourself, that, you know, you may have different experiences than other people, but at the end of the day, I mean, if that's what you enjoy doing is riding a motorcycle, and if that's how you transition from this earth, you know, who am I to judge? So that, I just wanted to kind of share that for all the people who want to get a motorcycle and you hear all the negativity, you're gonna die. Hell yeah, we're all gonna die. Like, tell me something I don't know. But when you receive all the negativity, just rise above it. It's your goals. Maybe sometimes hold it close to the chest. It's not for everybody. It's for you. Other people don't need to understand and realize your goals. Mainly, only you need to reach your goals and understand them. You don't need a cheerleading squad. Is it great? Yes. But like I said, this is for all those people who, one, you tell people that you want to ride a motorcycle and you're just faced with negativity. Rise above it. Make your bitch ass haters like see you succeed. Let them see you be successful. Like, that's the way to, that's the way to win, you know? You're right, and trust me, this is my therapy. Fuck your couch. So now that you have the context of like my history with motorcycles and some of the experiences I went through prior to getting my endorsement, I'm ready to dive into my story. I'm ready to get into the tea. So let's just say the year is 2022 and I'm living in Texas. And I'm really big on manifestation. And so one of the ways in which I work on my manifestation is I look for opportunities in which it's not my reality right now, but it gives me the opportunity to imagine and daydream. So I like to window shop. So one day, 2020, I happened to go into a motorcycle shop. And I like to just sit on the bikes, talk to the salesperson, pretend to run numbers, get an ideal, take pictures of me on the bike, work on my manifestation. But one of the times that I went into the motorcycle shop, I met a young man by the name of Jimmy, and he educated me on what the process would be to get my endorsement in the state of Texas. And so he gave me this flyer. And what this flyer is, it is information on the training course for the motorcycle safety course. So the Motorcycle Safety Foundation, I recommend that if you've never ridden a motorcycle, I recommend that you take a course. This course is pretty popular, the Motorcycle Safety Foundation. Harley has a course. So look for courses in your city. I had been sitting on this course and this flyer for about a year before I was able to actually attend. So going back to me working on my manifestation, I have a prayer closet, or I have my sacred space in which I would sit. So I would keep this in that space. And over the period of time, I would just read through to see like what the different requirements were, the price. The school, I would say all in all, maybe it was like $350 to go to the school. So finally, a year later, a financial opportunity presents itself in which I came up on some money and I was able to enroll in the school. So when January 2024 hit, I was enrolled in motorcycle safety school. And so the first step for the school was completing a 5-hour online course before you could attend school. And this was my certificate. And then school was about 2 days long. When we were in school, we got the opportunity to ride the bikes. The bikes that we were riding on, I would say they're Groms. They were very, very old bikes. Very old bikes, but grateful for them nonetheless. We learned the proper way to start the bike, proper way to park the bike. What I learned is that wherever your head goes is where your bike goes. So always have like that follow through. We learned how to inspect our bikes. There was different drills that we had to do in which our instructor showed us how to do the drill and then we proceeded to do the drill. The class was pretty small. I was the only female. Maybe there was about 10 of us. I will say that one of my challenges in the class was just like that dialogue of like my gender and me being a female and me believing that people were just projecting all these thoughts of me not being capable of riding a bike. So I had to overcome that inner dialogue. On the second day of class, it was raining. So as much as that was a challenge, I'm glad that I got the opportunity to ride my bike in the rain. I did not have the proper gear. The gloves that I had were the gloves that you would give your kids if it was a cold, snowy day, some gloves you could get at Walmart. And so with that being said, my I was challenged a lot with the clutch. So I kept stalling my bike. One, I may have been stalling it, one, because the bike was so damn old. Two, like the handle, the grip wasn't comfortable to me. So I can see where people change like their grips so that it wouldn't, is not uncomfortable. Three, like I said, the gloves didn't keep my hands warm. So I had some challenges. The dialogue that I experienced with that challenge was just wanting to quit and wanting to give up. Anybody who truly knows me knows that I love heat. So I'm a person who I'd rather be sweating, I'd rather be hot. so that I could like take off clothes versus having to put clothes on. So that definitely was a challenge. So it was a 2-day course. I met a really awesome friend that I keep in contact who he had already been riding bikes for years. He just never had his endorsement. So him and I keep in contact. He's like my motorcycle crush. He has like 3 motorcycles and he does like all the upgrades on his bike. So he's always sharing that with me. So I did the course. I don't know if there's anything else I would, the course was great. I mean, the inner child in me had fun learning, just going fast and doing turns. And there would be times where I would just like, fuck it and release the brake and just let the bike ride. So it was an awesome experience all in all. I will say that when it came time to take the test, I did have to take the test twice. I did fail the test the first time because there's only so many times you can miss. So as much as I was discouraged, and my friend from motorcycle school, I'm gonna call him D for now, he was really encouraging. He was like, you got this, you can do this. I will say that I let the voices get to me. I just let the voices of, you can't do this, you can't do this, like kind of get the best of me. When I did get to take the test twice, the second time, nobody was around and I was able to pass the test. So I'm grateful for the whole experience. A part of me wants to take the course again because by the time I get my motorcycle, it just always was like that fear that if I didn't get my motorcycle soon, I was going to lose my skills. So a part of me considers taking the course twice. I don't know, or either just meeting up with D and practicing with him once I do get my bike. So my goal was to get my motorcycle in the month of April, but that didn't happen. The reason I took the course in January, I wanted to have my motorcycle by April just because I was scared that I would lose my skills. I was going to buy a Grom from D for about like $3,000 because I work from home and that would be like a great bike for me to just practice and build my skills on and just show everybody around me like, your girl can ride a bike. What ended up changing was I got a promotion at work at the time and I was gonna need to go on site. So at that point I started looking into just getting the bike that I really wanted, which was a Honda. Either I was gonna get like a Honda 300 or a Honda 500. Of course, everybody would say get a 300, but the biggest debate between the two bikes was I didn't want to have to turn around and have to get another bike 6 months later or a year later. I really wanted a bike that I could grow in and just have for a period of time. So I decided not to get the Grom from D, and I had started looking for motorcycles, Hondas to get in different prices. They were running about, and I wanted a Honda with an ABS. So I would say they were running maybe $5,000-$6,000 to get, which was not too bad. But when I went to get the bike, you know, I don't know if I shared with you guys, but I think 2018 I had to file bankruptcy, which was the biggest blessing of my life. But ever since then, I've just been trying to be move the smartest that I can move with myself. And so although I've done a lot of work on my credit score and it's up, I have 2 debts that I need to, one I was paying off and one I need to work on paying off. And so because a motorcycle for banks is considered like a toy, it's not considered a necessity, I wasn't approved for the bike. I pretty much have to work on my credit. Well, with me getting that freaking blow of no, of not being able to get my bike in April, it was like a big tower moment for me. And for those of you who are into tarot, a tower moment is like a rude awakening, something way bigger than yourself that makes you realize like there's some corrections that needed to be made. And so with not getting my motorcycle and that being a goal, like a conscious goal since like 2019, and here it being 2014 and not meeting that goal, it made me sit and reassess my life and made me look at life like, well, what's the point of being a boss at work if you can't get the stuff you want? What's the point of XYZ if you can't get what you really want? So my inner child just threw the biggest temper tantrum ever. Like, fuck all this shit. Don't none of this matter. You know, growing up, I grew up, I would say, in poverty. And so deciding to blow up my whole fucking spot, yes, it was challenging, but unfortunately, like, I thrive in lack sometimes. I thrive in challenge. I thrive in being hungry. I thrive in, we started at the bottom, now we here. Like, that's kind of like a thriving spot for me. Like, that push, like, it's like being in the gym and just like, lifting weight. It's like, I really thrive in being hungry. So, at that point, I requested a demotion from work. Of course, everybody turned their heads, but I'm not big on following. I'm big on being the leader. I'm big on, if everybody is going this way, I'm finna go that way. I was working on ending my, I had a partner after being celibate for 4 years. I decided to start practicing sex for 1 year. Nothing serious, just practicing sex. I decided to, like, end that and just really go back to the drawing board. Very angry, very disappointed, a little bit of shame, because I had been telling everybody, like, I have my endorsement, I'm gonna get a bike, and not to get it. It was really hard for me to hear that it wasn't no, Bridget, it's just not yet, you know, there's more work to do. And so finally being able to hear, like, it's just not yet, I was able to just go back to the drawing board, build a new blueprint. I don't have my bike yet, and I know I'm gonna get my bike. It's just a matter of, when am I gonna get my bike? I'm patient. I waited this long. I'm glad that I've had this whole experience. I'm glad that I didn't get a bike when sooner. I understand why everybody was like, no, Bridget, you didn't get a bike. I'm glad that I've waited till I am more mature. I'm more wiser. There's a motorcycle mentality that you have to have. I mean, before, anybody who knew me before, I was a very reckless driver. I didn't care. I didn't have a passion for life. So, hell, if I was going to die by any means, it probably was going to be in my car, because I just had an I didn't care attitude. So I do understand why everybody was like, you don't need to get a motorcycle. But I am wiser. I am mature. And I am ready. And I know that. So in the month of May, I was able to schedule an appointment to the DMV here in Texas so that I can take my endorsement and get it put on my driver's license. So the Texas experience for DMV, you do need to make an appointment. You cannot just walk in. I definitely tried to walk in, but that's not the way it goes. It's better to have an appointment, especially if you are adding an endorsement, because you want to ensure that you have all your paperwork. I believe I was in the DMV maybe like 2 hours. I had all the proper paperwork and I was able to get my motorcycle endorsement. So I am proud of myself. I don't have my bike yet, but I have my endorsement. You know, with social media being the way it is, you always see everybody just get their stuff instantly. This is like everybody's so into instant gratification. And for me, that's not my life. That's not the story of my life. I tend to have to work for things, which I'm okay with that, because it makes me appreciate and value everything that I have. So my next step, once life lines up, is to get a motorcycle. And I do look forward to sharing that journey with you guys. But that was my story on how I got my motorcycle endorsement in the state of Texas. I did it, bitches.